development, sustainability, innovation, breakthroughs, progress. But if that's our future, then what's our present? Discrimination, bias, prejudice, denial, human rights abuses. Hi, I'm Niharika and I'm a grade 8 student at National Public School, Indranagar, and also a 1M1B future leader. I strongly believe that as humans, we all deserve equal rights. The tribal groups are the segment in society that suffer the most from human rights violations. They face constant harassment from various forces and are very prone to eviction. Despite the government's efforts to assist them as compensation, the middleman usually denies them basic rights, including land, water, and shelter, among others. In one part of Kerala, 22,402 people were denied their rights. The most common claim when doing so is that the tribals don't have the proper government identification and therefore they can't access the provisions. Among the 461 tribes that fall under the Scheduled Tribes category, there are at least 174 unrecognized ones who do not fall under that category and thus do not receive government support. And even among the 461 Scheduled Tribes, only 25 to 30% of them still possess some land holdings. I have started my project on empowering the indigenous communities. Project Ribali aims to equip the tribal communities with proper government identification so that they can gain access to the various ventures run by the government for their benefit. I also intend to encourage the tribal groups to hold up their heritage and become frontline climate change warriors, as they are the ones who are truly spiritually connected with Mother Nature. For this project, I have decided to work on 5 different hamlets with the help of my NGO partner, Vanavasi Vikasa Kendra. We will be conducting 1-day long Aadhaar implementation camps, which will be followed by small sessions on government documents, taking action for climate change and advocacy. So far, I have impacted 124 people directly and 500 plus families indirectly. I had started a community fundraiser and raised ₹10,000. I raised another 9,000 by selling tribal handicrafts from the 17th of April to the 21st. I had even conducted an Ayurveda health camp on 12th April with the help of Ahalya Hospital. But I intend to scale this project to much higher levels in the future. I plan to organize social events like online performances, maybe even showcasing tribal talent as a means of spreading awareness in society and earning public support. This would never have been possible if it weren't for the opportunity provided by the 1M1B organization. Thanks to 1M1B, I have learned how to look at things from a different perspective and how to generally be more empathetic to my surroundings. Even my communication skills have improved a lot. I would like to thank my mentors Swati and Rima for providing me with constant support, which has helped me to lay the foundation that is present today. I hope that I will be able to continue advocating for tribal people to help secure their rights and include them in the developmental process so they live safer, healthier, and more prosperous lives, as the indigenous people are the heritage of humankind. Thank you.